Well, Canon just released a firmware update giving users the ability to now record in Canon Log 3 on the EOS R5, and Lord willing, we'll get this on the 1DX Mark III as well. What's going on? My name is Tyler Edwards. I'm a filmmaker based out of Colorado. In this video, I want to talk about a LUT pack, a LUT bundle, if you will, that I've made, that I've compiled for specifically for the R5, and if we get the same Canon Log 3 on the 1DX Mark III, this will apply to 1DX 3 users as well. Now, I'm not gonna go into detail of each of the different LUTs, but what I'll do is I'll just kind of overlay footage and kind of cycle through some of the different LUTs so you can kind of see what they look like and kind of give you an idea of some of the different LUTs, different folders, different packs that you'll get within this bundle. But I'm not gonna go over each one of those, but anyways. So what I have is I have three different kind of LUTs, LUT flavors, if you will. So I have Canon Log 3, Rec 709. So if you wanna stay in the Rec 709 color space, for whatever reason, maybe using this as a B cam, your R5 or whatever, to as a B cam to the C200, this would be a great LUT pack to both use on the C200 and the R5 if you're recording in 8-bit on the C200 in Canon Log 3, obviously, because the C200 only records in a Rec 709 color space. So you want to stick with Rec 709 on your B camera to be able to match them as close as possible. So moving on, we have Canon Log 2 and Canon Log 3 Cinema Gamut LUTs. I have put these in different folders just to kind of keep them separate a little bit, but they are both Cinema Gamut LUTs. One is optimized for Canon Log 3 and the other one is optimized for Canon Log 2. So why would you use the Canon Log 2 Cinema Gamut LUTs on this, on your R5, for example? Well, if you're recording in 8K RAW or RAW light and you drop those files into your NLE, those are going to be encoded for the most part. I don't know any NLEs that don't encode it this way. Is it's gonna encode it as Canon Log 2 in the Canon Cinema Gamut. And that's your flattest log curve that Canon has available, at least at the time of recording this, which maximizes the dynamic range of your image. Now your Canon Log 3 is gonna be what you're gonna use if you're recording internally and you're not recording in RAW. You have a setting to set to Canon Log 3 and the Canon Cinema Gamut. And the reason why the Canon Cinema Gamut is so great, because it's a wider color space than both Rec 709 and Rec 2020, which is why I don't even have any Rec 2020 LUTs on my website, because with the Canon Cinema Gamut, it kind of makes Rec 2020 obsolete, in my opinion. At least when you're recording on these cameras for an acquisition format, it's always best to record more information than you're gonna need in post. So recording in a Canon Cinema Gamut, even if you're on a Rec 709 timeline or Rec 709 export, having all the additional information to start with is much better than being limited in information, say when you're recording just in a Rec 709 color space. So that's kind of a general overview of the different LUTs in my LUT pack. Now, one thing to know is, for the most part, with the exception of like maybe three or four LUTs out there, I'd have to go back and double check, but most of them are technical transform LUTs, meaning it's just kind of an accurate Rec 709 transform LUT to kind of get you in a starting point. The whole reason why I made these is I just didn't like how the Canon provided LUTs looked. I just wasn't happy with what they did with skin tones and with different colors like blue and stuff like that. So that's what I did. I just set out to basically kind of correct those things that I didn't personally like about the Canon provided LUTs. Now, that being said, most of mine are technical transform LUTs, just to kind of give you accurate highlight roll off, skin tones, all that kind of stuff. You know, as long as your camera's white balance and exposure and everything is set properly in camera, my LUTs do not fix that, nor do any LUTs out there. But these are kind of just to kind of give you a good starting point for the grading. And I do have a couple of more creative LUTs out there, and one I would consider kind of like maybe middle of the road, and that's my Faithful Crush LUT, which is for the Cinema Gamut LUTs. And those are that's my absolute favorite LUT. For I pretty much apply this to all of my C-Log 2 or C-Log 3 Cinema Gamut footage, just because I love the way that it looks. And I kind of consider that one like a middle of the road LUT, because it has somewhat of a creative tendency toward it, instead of having, you know, more of a instead of a more of a broadcast video-y contrast look that you may get from one of my other LUTs, especially maybe my base LUT. I still think the base LUT looks really, really good, but it is definitely a little bit more punchy than say the Faithful LUT. And the Faithful LUT just kind of has like a gradual roll off from highlights to shadows and stuff, but it's just my favorite one, especially as a starting point. I just love it. It looks really awesome. But then I have like Indie and Vibe Crush, especially, which those are more, and my Moody one as well. Those are more creative LUTs. The Moody one kind of pushes more blues into the shadows. And then the Vibe and Indie LUT just kind of give you, like the Indie one kind of gives you like somewhat of an orange and teal look, but nothing like too intense. And the Vibe Crush definitely has its own vibe, does really kind of funky things with the greens and all that kind of stuff. But again, I'm not going to go into detail on all the different LUTs. We would be here for way too long, and I'm sure I've already been here way too long. But hopefully the footage that I've overlaid over this video is kind of giving you an idea of how these different LUTs look. So yep, these LUTs are great. There's a great LUT pack. Even if you have a C500 Mark II and an R5, this is a great LUT pack to have for both of those, because maybe you're recording Canalog 2 Canon Cinema Gamut on your C500 Mark II or C300 Mark III, whatever the case may be, and recording Canalog 3 Cinema Gamut on your R5. Applying the C-Log 2 and C-Log 3 variants of the Cinema Gamut LUTs will pretty much make your cameras ready to go right off the bat. Dropping a simple LUT on there will make it look really good and ready to go. Now, different camera sensors are gonna have a little bit different color signs from each other, so you're always gonna have to have a little bit of tweaking between different cameras. But for example, this shot right here is on my 1DX Mark III in 5.5K RAW. And then the B cam I set up was the R5. Set up on Canon Log 3 and the Canon Cinema Gamut. And you can see I got them to match super quick, both using the Faithful Crush LUT C-Log 2 for the RAW and C-Log 3 for the R5. So anyways, I hope you found this helpful, useful, anything. There wasn't a lot of questions about my LUT, so I figured I'd just make this video to kind of clear the air a little bit. If you want to purchase them, there is a link down in the description below. I really appreciate it. I have hundreds and hundreds of happy customers with these LUTs, and I get really good feedback all the time about these LUTs. Canalog 3 Cinema Gamut opens up the R5 to a whole new world, in my opinion, and I think it kind of unleashes the R5. The full potential of the R5, and hopefully Canon, the 1DX Mark III. Please give it to us soon, because that kind of unleashes it to be, you know, really as a real true B cam and to the cinema cameras out there, and a true hybrid cinema camera out there. So, well, your definition of cinema camera can be whatever. But anyways, yeah, thank you so much. Please buy my LUTs. If you have a Canon, if you don't have a Canon camera, don't buy LUTs. That'd be silly, unless you just want to support the channel, which in that case, I very much appreciate it. And all of my LUT sales that I make, I pretty much just put right back into this YouTube channel. It's the whole reason why I made them, just to make a little bit extra dollars out there to invest in whatever the case may be to talk about on this channel, whether it be lighting or grip or whatever the case may be. So anyways, thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna stop rambling on. Did not make any notes for this video, and it definitely shows. But if you're still here, maybe just hit that thumbs up button to support that algorithm life. Anyways, love y'all. See you later. Peace.